University Red Raiders. The starting offensive lineup for Washington State, number 83, Tom Kelly at swing end. At quick tackle, number 74, Bob Trigstad. At quick guard, number 65, Jim Nelson. At center, number 52, Ron Verlich. At strong guard, number 68, Wayne Foster. At strong tackle, number 72, Joe Broker. And at strong end, number 88, Rich Sharon. The starting offensive backfield for Washington State, number 15, Dave Peterson of Wenatchee at quarterback. At left half, number 22, Clarence Williams. At fullback, number 33, Larry Elmas. And starting for the Cougars at right halfback, and incidentally a co-captain for the Texas Tech ball game, number 10, Mike Cadigan. We'll be set for the opening kickoff in just a moment, but first, here's a word from the man from Northwestern. Number 68, Wayne Foster, will kick off for Washington State. Temperature in the mid-70s at kickoff time on a beautiful day for football in North Texas. The Cougars, of course, in their traveling white uniform, and Foster has to go up and tee up the ball again as we wait for the opening kickoff. Now he's ready to go. The ball game is just about underway. A long, deep kick. Donnie Anderson waits for it deep in the end zone. Fumbles it, picks up, and will down the football. He's Tech's great triple threater, number 44, and we'll be seeing a lot of him in a ball game to come. Tech will put it in play at their own 20-yard line. Red Raiders in red and white getting ready to get the first offensive play on the ball game. Tom Wilson, number 13 at quarterback for Texas Tech. Wilson on a straight-ahead drive, breaking into the open, all the way up across the 35 to about the 38-yard line. Loveless carrying the football, and that will be a first down for Texas Tech on the first offensive play. Tech at their own 37-yard line. Wilson giving it again to, or this time to Weiss, and he hits the left side and gains about 3 yards. Second down and a long seven for the Red Raiders. No score in the ball game. It'll be Abel kicking out of Roth's hole. It's up. It is good, and the score, Washington State 7, Texas Tech University nothing. And perhaps you see the Texas Tech mascot, the famed Red Raider, on his black horse as he rides around the double T sign at the north end of this beautiful Jones Stadium.
Well, Bert, at this stage in the ball game, things look pretty good. We got a quick touchdown lead.
Well, that helps, Dale, of course. Clarence did a real fine job maneuvering the ball into the end zone. I thought that early in this stage of the game that we're doing quite well. Real proud of the kids at this point.
Foster to boot it again for the second time in the ball game. Donnie Anderson fields at the 2. He's up across the 20 and then runs into a solid wall of gray jerseys just short of his own 25-yard line. First and 10, Texas Tech at their own 25. Man in motion moving to the right side. Fumble. Cougars get it again on the 23-yard line. The second consecutive Texas Tech fumble, giving the Cougars possession again deep in Tech territory. First and 10, Cougars just short of the Tech 23-yard line. Kelly, the swing man on the left side. That's Cadigan in motion. It's Williams after Elmas is faked, and Clance is going to run out of room and does, but still gained about 2 yards. Bud Norris flanked on the right side. On the delay trap, Williams can't get away and loses about 5 yards, back to about the 27. Kelly back in at swing end as the Cougars will change that swing end on, well, virtually every play. Williams moving in motion to the right. Cadigan carrying, watch him pass. He hits Williams, but Clarence can't get away and just gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Cougars will attempt a field goal. Abel will kick it from the 35 at an angle, meaning he'll have to boot that ball 45 yards, but he is kicking with the wind. It is not going to be any good. Way low, and so the score remains Washington State 7, Texas Tech University nothing. Red Raiders go on the offensive for the third time, starting from their own 20. Straight ahead. And up across the 25 to about the 27-yard line, Jerry Shaw making the tackle. That was Jim Zanios, the fullback, carrying the ball. Second and 3, Tech. Their own 26 and a half. Anderson in motion to the left side. Lennius again gets away and fights his way to the 30, and that should be good enough for another Tech first down. Red Raiders have an end winged on the left side. They play straight ahead football, pick up about 3 yards, pounding the right side. That was Zanius again carrying the football. Second down, a short 7 for the Red Raiders. At their own 34-yard line, Donnie Anderson moving in motion to the left. It's Zanius piling the middle. He's across the 35, gains maybe 2 yards, and the whole center of that Cougar line in to help bring him down. Red Raiders on a third down, 3.5 situation. It's Anderson. He's up to near the 40, but did he make the first down? We'll have to wait and see. He didn't, and Donnie Anderson is back in kick formation on his own 27-yard line, and time is called. Tech wants to get the defensive platoon in. That time out cost the Red Raiders 5 yards. Ball moved back just short of the 35. Cougars are sending 3 men back. Gaskins and Williams are the 2 deep ones. Anderson, the left-footed kicker, boots it. Bill Gaskins is going to signal for a fair catch and takes it at about the 27.5-yard line where the Cougars will put it in play. So the Cougars on the offensive for the third time in the ball game. One of those times they score. The other time they try to field goal and fail. Now Almas breaks in the open, goes all the way up to the 39-yard line. And the last man who had a chance to get him did. Cougar first down, just short of their own 40. Peterson at quarterback. Williams starts to move. It's Almas carrying again, going the hard way up the middle, and he gains about 2 yards at the most before being piled up by 3, the defensive middle line of the Texas Tech Red Raiders. Peterson faking to Almas, gets to the 45, maybe the 46-yard line, and it'll be third and about 4 with a big play coming up for the Cougars. Ball at the Cougar 46. Cadigan moving in motion. Peterson to Elmas. Larry trying to spin his way, and I don't think he made the first down. Neither does the Tech crowd think he made it, but they may call for a measurement. Now the Cougars will have a 4th-and-1 situation on their own 49. And the Cougars elect to go for it. 4th-and-1. Elmas, and he got it. In the Tech territory. Gamble paid off for the Cougars. 1st-and-10. Gonna swing in, comes to the side. Peterson sets his offense, sends Williams in motion to the right, takes a handoff to Cadigan, throws down the middle, completes to Tom Kelly at the 38, close to another Cougar first down. 2.5 yards, Shaw goes to the right side. Cadigan moving in motion to the left, Peterson faking a handoff. Throws long, he's got him down, and overthrows him into the end zone, intended for Jerry Shaw. Still a 0.5 yard to go for the Cougars. Now 3rd down, Cadigan on the right side. It's Elmas carrying, and Larry, well, I don't know. Did he make it or not? He didn't have far to go, but by George, he didn't go very far either against that Tech forward wall, and the officials may have to call for a measurement. By the nose of the football, the Cougars got a 1st down. Kelly, the swing man on the right side, Williams in motion. It's Cadigan. They're chasing him. Look out, Mike. He can't get away. Lost at the 49. Big loss for the Cougars. So it's 2nd down at about 20. Cadigan wide to the left, and Bednaris wide right. Peterson to Williams, and Clancy tries the delay up the middle and can't get away, and the Cougars will be faced with another long yardage situation with 3rd down. A little more than a minute remaining to play in the first period. Cadigan in motion. Peterson to Williams, and again, the Red Raiders were looking for it, and Clarence has scoffed, and the Cougars will have a 4th-and-long yardage situation. Kelly will kick it from about his own 38. Red Raiders have a single safety on their own 12. Low pass from center. Kelly angles it over to the sidelines, and it goes out of bounds across the way. 1st and 10, Texas Tech at their own 16-yard line. Man in motion to the right side. Straight ahead drive with a penalty marker down and a gain of about 3 yards. The penalty was against the Cougars for offside, moving the ball to the 21. Texas Tech now in a 1st and 5 situation. Man in motion to the right side. It's Donnie Anderson carrying, and he has his legs cut out from under him after a gain of 3 to the 23. About 0.5 minute remaining to play in the first period. Second down, two for the Red Raiders. Straight ahead drive and a gain of maybe a yard to the 25. The Red Raiders will still be about a half yard short of the first as time runs out in the first quarter. There's the whistle ending the first quarter with a score, Washington State University 7, Texas Tech nothing. Now here's a word from your local Ford dealer. Third and half a yard for the Red Raiders as the second quarter gets underway. At the Red Raider 25-yard line, Donnie Anderson dives on the right side and gets the first down with about a yard to spare. Tech in red and white, deep pitch to Anderson, tries to cut inside, gets to maybe the 31, gain of about, maybe 2 yards on the play before he's stopped by Jim Payton and Griffith. Second and five for Texas Tech, right end is split wide, man in motion going to the right side. It's Donnie Anderson on the weak side run, tries to cut away from Bill Gaskins and can't get away, and then a host of Cougars help throw him back at about the 34-yard line. Texas Tech still got the first down on the play. Jump pass down the middle, complete. Up at the 50-yard line for another Tech first down. Ball marked exactly at the midfield stripe. Texas Tech on the offensive. Cougars lead it 7-0 early in the second quarter. Pass on the side, overthrown, intended for Donnie Anderson, incomplete. Second and 10, Tech at the midfield stripe. Man in motion to the right side. Wilson to Anderson, and he finds a hole. Goes to about the 42 before Dempsey racks him up about 2 yards short of the first down. Wilson at quarterback, third down for the Red Raiders. Deep pitch to Donnie Anderson. He gets the first down inside the Cougar 35 to the 34. Red Raiders set their offense. Man in motion to the right side. It's Donnie Anderson again, and he has his legs cut out from under him after a gain of about 1 yard by Rich Sharon. Texas Tech, second and nine at the Washington State 33-yard line early in the second period. Wilson back to throw. Decides to run with it. Crosses the 30 to about the 29. Gain of about 4 on the play. Third and 5, Tech. Anderson to throw. Down the middle, complete. The ball. Still go, fumble. Cougars get it. Cougars recover the Tech fumble at their own 13-yard line and stop this Texas Tech drive. Incidentally, that was Larry Griffith who recovered that fumble. That's the third time in the ball game that Red Raiders have fumbled, the third time the Cougars have gotten it. Peterson rolling on the weak side. Elmas takes one man but can't get the other one, and he's thrown out of bounds for a loss inside the 10. Second down, 13 for the Cougars, deep in their own territory. They lead it 7-0, 10 minutes remaining to play in the first half. Clarence Williams, and Clarence dances away from a couple tacklers, still goes and goes across the 21-yard line. Big play for the Cougars as they'd like to retain possession of the football, third and two. Elmas, and he gets the first down with yards to spare all the way up to the 30. Kelly wide on the left side, Mike Cadigan split to the right. Peterson tries to follow Elmas through, and in a cloud of dust, he is swarmed under for about a 2 yard loss. No fumble, the ball had been blown dead, I believe. Yeah, the Cougars retain possession, second and little more than 11 to go, deep in their own territory. Williams starts to move in motion, and Elmas tries to bowl through the line, but is stopped for no gain. Third and 11, Cougars. Peterson to Mike Cadigan, and Cadigan doesn't go anywhere, and the Cougars will have to give up the football. Kelly will kick from his own 15. Raiders have a single safety back at about their own 37. Good kick. Fielded at a 27. Across the 30. Good block. And out of bounds, well near the 45 in Red Raider territory. First and 10, Texas Tech, just short of their own 45-yard line. Man in motion to the right side. Wilson to Wasey, and he moves for maybe 2 yards through the right side, and it'll be second down and about 7 for the Red Raiders. Ball at their own 47. Wilson on the deep pitch to Anderson, and the flag goes down as he crosses the midfield stripe to about the 49 in Cougar territory. Penalty apparently against Texas Tech. A holding penalty against Texas Tech moves the ball back to the Red Raider 34, making it second down and 20 yards to go. Wilson faking the handoff, going back to throw, being chased. And finally, Griffith gets him across the way with a horse collar tackle, but not after he gained back a good many of the yards lost on the preceding play. Third down, 11 for the Red Raiders. Ball just short of their own 43-yard line. Wilson again back to throw. Shoots a screen, completes it over on the left side. Breaks the man in the open. He's jarred loose from the football, but I think recovered it in midair. He did, and Tech gets the first down. Tech on the Cougar 44 after a good comeback play. Wisey, and he doesn't go anywhere. Gets maybe 2 yards, trying to cut in on the right side. Second down, Texas Tech. Cougars lead at 7-0. 5.5 remaining to play in the half. Wilson back to throw. Being chased, and man, he was banged out of bounds in front of the Red Raider bench down below us by Wally Dempsey, number 66. Third and 7, Tech. Ball at the Cougar 41. Wilson again back to throw. Hits Donnie Anderson on the screen again. And I think he goes out of bounds, but I also think he got the first down before he did. He did. Officials mark it at the Cougar 29. Tech on the offensive. Cougars lead at 7-0. Wilson back to throw. Being chased. Throws down. Got a man down. Or Anderson. Good catch. Touchdown. He ran into somebody down there. Jerry Shaw. But bounced off him and went on into the end zone. For Tech's first touchdown. So the Red Raiders now will attempt to tie it up, or they might go for two. Kick is up. It's good. It's a brand new ball game with 5 minutes and 22 seconds remaining to be played in the first half. Texas Tech 7, Washington State 7. Clarence Williams and Bill Gaskins are the deep men for the Cougars, standing inside the five, as you see, as Gill boots it. Bounces, and Clarence will let it go on into the end zone. Bill Gaskins in at wingback for the Cougars, replacing Mike Cadigan on offense. That's Williams in motion. Larry Elmas, and Larry goes for about 4 yards, and then he's just picked up and hurtled back. Second down, Cougars on a long five between the 24 and 25-yard line. Elmas again. Larry breaks in the open, crosses the 35, gets the first down up to near the 36-yard line. In less than 4.5 minutes of playing time remaining in the first half, 7-7, Gaskins in motion. He's got Elmas, but overthrow him, incomplete. Kelly, the swing man, goes to the left side. It's second down, 10 for the Cougars. Gaskins in motion. Peterson throws again, same play, and overthrew him. So the Cougars are in a 3rd and 10 situation. Peterson, he's going to keep it and runs out of running room on the far side at about the 47, well short of the first down. Tom Kelly will kick it from his own 29 on a 4th and 4 situation. 4:06 the time remaining in the second period. 7-7 ball game. If you join us late, Kelly boots it. Wobbly kick, bouncing. Fumble, and Gaskins has it. Touchdown, Cougars! How about that? As the ball, well, we knew the ball was going to have to start bouncing our way after those two tough breaks against Oregon State and that freak last week. And wait a minute, the officials are going to call it back? Well, let's wait and see. Now the officials' conference, although I did not see a penalty marker go down, but the scoreboard is not racking it up, and apparently they're going to rule it only as a recovery for the Cougars. But let's wait and see how the officials call it. Well, the officials say the ball touched the ground, and they nullify the touchdown, but the Cougars still have the football. Dave Peterson, and Pete gets down to about the 23. Well, it'll be close to another Cougar first down. Cougars didn't make it. They're second down and inches short of the first down. I guess we talked a little too soon about the ball starting to bounce the Washington State way for a change. Deep pitch to Williams. He got a good block in there from somebody. Along the sidelines, cuts in and drives and gets the first down easily to about the 13. 3 minutes and 22 seconds, the official time remaining in the second quarter, 7-7 ball game. Deep pitch again to Williams. Clarence tries to turn inside and is hit and dropped for about a 6-yard loss. Second down, 13 for the Cougars at the Texas Tech 15. Cattigan in motion to the left. It's Elmas and he's tripped up just short of the 10. Williams in motion, wide to the left, or I should say flanked wide to the left. It's Cattigan going in motion. Peterson to throw. Look out. He's stopped and hit at the 15. The Cougars will have a fourth down, may attempt a field goal. Bill Ebel will attempt it from about the 23, meaning it will have to travel 33 yards. The second time he's tried it in the ball game. It's up. It is good, and Washington State goes in front with a minute and a half remaining. In the first half, Washington State 10, Texas Tech 7. That's Wayne Foster to kick it for the Cougars. Donnie Anderson fields inside the 10. He's the great Tech triple threater. And back he goes. A host of white shirts hit him, and they'll mark it down somewhere around the 27 or 28-yard line. Red Raiders will put it in play. With just a little more than a minute remaining in the first half. Cougars lead it 10-7. That's Anderson. He's a great one, and he's across the 40 to the 42. First down, Red Raiders. 55 seconds, and Texas Tech will call time to stop the clock. Red Raiders have a first and 10 at their own 41-and-a-half-yard line. 10-7 Cougars, time running out in the first half. Delay to Anderson up the middle. He's got a big hole. Finally, pushed out of bounds by Gaskins and Forbes down around the Cougar 30-yard line as Anderson almost went all the way. They'll mark it at about the 31-and-a-half. But it was all for naught, clipping against the Red Raiders, moving them back to their own 30-yard line. First and 25, Anderson goes in motion. Straight ahead to the, well, about the 35 and stopped after a gain of about 5. It was Weissy carrying. Clark runs with a little less than half a minute remaining. Red Raiders aren't going to take a huddle. They want to get that clock stopped, which they do with 25 seconds exactly to play in the first half. Third down, Raiders, about 17. Back to throw is Wilson. He hits Anderson on the screen, and he falls, gets up, and gets to the 35, back to about where the play originally started. The clock continues to run. The Red Raiders are going to have to really hustle to get another play off in the half. They did not make it. The half ends with a score. Washington State University 10, Texas Tech University 7. I'll be back with Cougar head coach Bert Clark after this word from the man from Northwestern.
Well, things looked even better when we got the three-pointer and moved ahead of the Texas club again.
Right. During this first half, of course, we've had two or three people wide open on passes, and we failed to connect. It's a funny thing about our passing game. I can't understand why we can't lay the ball in there for these big strikes that we need to keep our drives going, but we do have a halftime lead. It's very fortunate.
We'll be back with the second half kickoff after this word from your local Ford dealer. Texas Tech will kick off to start the second half. Gaskins and Williams are the deep men, a low driving kick. And Gaskins starts for it and, as you see, decides to let it go on out of the end zone and up on the hill. Kelly comes wide right as the Cougars get their first offensive series started in the second half. Peterson giving it to Clarence Williams, and Clarence goes for maybe 2 yards, and then is stopped by the whole center of that Texas Tech line. Second and about 7 for the Cougars. 10-7, Cougars lead it. Cattigan in motion. That's Almas across the 25 to the 26. Bill Gaskins is in, replacing Cadigan at wingback. Kelly is the swing man to the left side. Gaskins moves in motion to the right. Peterson almost tripped up, and then he does get back across the line of scrimmage, but he will be short of the first down. Kelly at about his own 14. Raiders have a single safety backing up near their own 35. Low pass from center, but Kelly gets it away. It's a high kick. Bounces over, and the Cougar is right there to make sure that Tech doesn't move it anywhere, and it will be blown dead and is at the 31. Texas Tech going on the offensive, and immediately they call time to get the offensive platoon in the ball game. Red Raiders go on the offensive with the first down at their own 31-and-a-half-yard line. Cougars lead at 10-7, 12-41 in the third quarter. Wilson to Anderson, and he breaks in the open, gets up across the 40, near a Tech first down. Donnie Anderson. Red Raiders did get the first down. Man in motion to the right side. Wilson again, back to throw, shoots one out in the flat. He's got a man open, and he runs out of bounds at the 43, another Tech first down. Tech at the Cougar 43. Anderson comes in motion to the left side, and a straight-ahead drive play gains at best a half yard. Second down, about 9 for the Raiders. Anderson again in motion. Wilson to throw. He's got a man wide open. Balch and hits him. And John Forbes immediately hits Balch. But the Raiders have a first down at the Cougar 25. Texas Tech on the offensive. Man in motion to the right side. Anderson, the second man through. He finds a hole. He's inside the 15. Another Tech first down. Donnie Anderson, who didn't have a great first half, but is certainly looking great early in the second half. Ball at the Cougar 13-yard line. First and 10 for the Red Raiders. Man in motion. Deep pitch. Texas Tech touchdown. And the Red Raiders go out in front for the first time in the ballgame. Texas Tech leading 13-10 will attempt to make it 14. Kick is up, and it is good, and it is Texas Tech 14, Washington State 10, 10 minutes and 40 seconds remaining to be played in the third quarter. Bill Gaskins at the goal line, Clarence Williams on about the 10. The kick goes deep and out of the end zone. The Cougars will put it in play on their own 20. Kelly, the swing man, is wide on the right side. Cadigan is back in at wing back. Williams starts moving in motion. Elmas, and he gets 2 yards and down go penalty markers. The penalty was against the Cougars for holding, moving the ball back to the 10-yard line. It'll be first down and 20 yards to go. Williams starts to move. It's Elmas trying to find some room, and the center of that Tech line closes up quickly. Kelly wide on the right side. Peterson on the deep pitch to Clarence. But Clarence is going to run out of running room over on the far side, and he does up near the 15. For a gain of only 5, it'll be third and 15 still for the Cougars. Kelly wide left, Bill Gaskins in at wingback, wide to the right to try to go up the middle, but didn't fool the Red Raiders, and the Cougars pick up only 2 and are now faced with a kicking situation from deep in their own territory. Kelly will be on his own 4. Raiders with a single safety back near the midfield stripe. Kelly boots it, and it's a beauty. Finally fielded at the 35 and out of bounds to stop the clock and give the Red Raiders a chance to get some offensive football players in. And the Cougars, of course, will now bring in the defense. First and 10, Red Raiders just across their own 40-yard line. Man in motion to the right side. Deep pitch to Donnie Anderson. He turns inside, gets up to the 45 for a gain of about 5. John Forbes in on the play. Tom Hedemark also. Second down and a long 4 for the Red Raiders. They lead it 14-10. Donnie Anderson, and boy, does he have his legs chopped out from under him by John Forbes. But Red Raiders get a first down at the Cougar 47. About 8.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. jump pass, the ball's complete. Gaskins and Forbes get him at the 30, but it's another Texas Tech first down. First and 10 at the 30. Deep pitch to Donnie Anderson. He lost his footing as he turned, and that was slowed him by half a step, and the Cougars got him at the line of scrimmage. Well, the first half was pretty much all Cougars. They scored 10 points and looked like they had another six, but the officials called it back in a rather questionable play. But so far the second half has been just as much all Texas Tech. Second down and a long nine for the Red Raiders, and they lead it 14-10. Blanker on the right side, Matt in motion to the right. Wilson to Anderson. Peyton gets him at about the 26-yard line. Third and five. Fake handoff. Wilson rolling out, and he gets the first down, still on his feet, and finally is racked up inside the 10. It'll be first and goal for the Red Raiders. With a little more than 6.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter, Texas Tech, first and goal at the 10. They lead it 14-10. Deep pitch, Weissey, and he fights his way for four to the Cougar six. Second down, Texas Tech. It's Donnie Anderson on a straight-ahead power play for a gain of two to the Cougar three. Third and goal. Man in motion on a deep pitch to Donnie Anderson, and he is stopped just short of the goal line. Fourth down, and you can see it, half a yard from pay dirt for the Red Raiders. They get it. Flag down. No touchdown. Apparently, they offside Washington State, and of course, Texas Tech will refuse the penalty. Well, the penalty assessed puts the Raiders back in that same situation, and this time they make it, no doubt about it, as the hands go up and the cannon sounds, and Texas Tech out in front now by 10 points with a conversion attempt coming up. The kick is good, but there's a penalty marker down. Looked like the Cougar right side defensively broke, but let's wait and see what the officials call it. Well, I'm not guessing too good in this ball game. The Cougar right side got back in time, but Texas Tech was guilty of illegal motion, so they get penalized 5 yards, but of course we'll try it again. And this time they booted through, the cannon sounds, and it's Texas Tech 21, Washington State 10, 4:59 remaining in the third quarter. Fullback Ken Gill to kick off for Texas Tech. Another long, deep kick. Williams downs it in the end zone, and the Cougars will move it out to the 20. Now the Cougars try to get back in the ball game from their own 20-yard line. Clarence Williams, and Clarence gets about 7 to the Cougar 27. Second and 3, Cougars. Larry Elmas straight ahead, and he is up near the first down. They may have to call for a measurement. Well, as you see, the Cougars are about a foot short because they have to get to the 30 for the first down. It's third down. Elmas, and he gets the first down, and down goes a penalty flag. Bad news for the Cougars. Illegal use of the hands, putting them back to their own 15. It'll be third down and 15 yards to go. Peterson down the middle, completes it at the 22-yard line to Tom Kelly. Fourth and 8, and Kelly to kick at the 10. Almost blocked. Boy, somebody, that defensive left end was in there quickly. Ball will roll and will finally roll dead on about the Tech 33. So the Red Raiders go on the offensive, leading 21-10 with just a little bit less than 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Donnie Anderson, and he's across the line of scrimmage for a short gain of about 1 yard. Second and 9 for the Red Raiders. Out of bounds at across the 40 at about the 41. Third, 3.5. Tech 21, Cougars 10. 2.5 remaining in the third quarter. Wilson rolling to the right. Good protection. Throws. Completes for Henderson. A great catch across the way. Just inbounds. First down, Red Raiders. Ball off the Cougar 37. Straight ahead drive with Zanius carry, and he crosses the 35 to, well, about the 34.5. Second down, 7, Texas Tech. Anderson in motion. Wilson to throw. Hits Anderson on the side, and he is pulled down at the 34-yard line. Third and 7, Texas Tech. Wilson on the look in. Hits his man at the 23-yard line. Tech has another first down on the march. First down at the 23, a little less than a minute remaining. In the third quarter, that is. Shaw pulls him down across the way after a gain of about 4. Second down for Texas Tech. Anderson in motion. Wilson to throw. Incomplete at the 5-yard line, batted away by John Forbes. Half a minute remaining in the third quarter. Third down situation for the Red Raiders. Man in motion to the right. Deep pitch to the tailback, Donnie Anderson. He gets out of somebody's grasp and finally is hauled down inside the 10. It'll be first and goal, Texas Tech. First and goal and about the 9.5. Wilson fakes the handoff. Keats gets away, and then he doesn't. Wally Dempsey hit him up the 14, 13-yard line. So they have to hustle to get a playoff, and they're not going to make it. There's the end of the third period with the score, Texas Tech 21, Washington State 10. Now here's a word from the man from Northwestern. Second down for Texas Tech, and goal to go on the 13 as we start the fourth period. Fumble. Cougars should have it. They do. Bill Gaskins gets it to stop this Tech drive on the Cougar 23. Dave Peterson at quarterback. It's a good block from Elmas and then runs out of bounds across the way. Cougars now will bring in the offensive platoon. Second down. Cattigan in motion. Peterson incomplete. Intended for Larry Elmas. Third and 9, Williams moving, Peterson throws, incomplete, intended for Tom Kelly. Kelly will kick it from the 10, and the Cougars unable to get an offensive. Bad pass from center, look out, Kelly's got to get it out of there. It won't matter much because Texas Tech will have a first and goal. Red Raiders, of course, with a first and goal at the 7. Anderson dives across the 5 to the 4. Second down, goal for Texas Tech. Straight ahead near the goal line. Did he get in? The officials are going to mark it down about half a yard short. Third. Touchdown, Texas Tech. Red Raiders will try to make it 4 straight from the point after line. The kick is up. It is good, easily, almost banging off a window of the Athletic Administration office down there to make it Texas Tech 28, Washington State 10 in the fourth quarter. So the Red Raiders kick off again. This time it's a low driving kick. They've been booting them in the end zone most of the game. Bill Gaskins has it. Right up the middle. Tries to spin away and falls across to the 36-yard line. Cougars trying to get something generated from their own 36-yard line. Peterson to Williams, and Clarence still on his feet, goes up across the 45 for a first down to Cougars at the 48. Shaw wide right. Peterson on a keeper goes straight ahead into Texas Tech territory for a gain of, well, about 4 yards. 11.5 minutes remaining in the ball game as Larry Elmas hits the right side and is down about 2 yards short of another Cougar first down in Texas Tech territory. Shaw wide on the right side, third and a long yard. Drive to the 40, and that should be good enough. It is for a Cougar first down near the 40-yard line. Cattigan in motion. fumble, and the Red Raiders have it at the 45 in Red Raider territory at their own 45-yard line. Texas Tech taking over. Still fairly early in the fourth quarter, the Red Raiders have a pretty substantial lead and gain 7 yards on the first play. They lead it 28-10 with just a little less than 10 minutes remaining to be played in the football game. Second and three, Texas Tech, man in motion to the right side. Wilson to Donnie Anderson, and he found some daylight and then slipped and fell. It still got the Red Raider first down. Officials mark it down just across the 40 in Cougar territory. Across the 35 to about the 34-yard line with Zanius carrying for the Red Raiders. Second down, five. Anderson in motion to the left for the Red Raiders. Robles carrying, and he is stopped after a short gain at the 33. Third down, three. Red Raiders, man in motion. Deep pitch to Loveless again, and he is horse-collared short of the 30-yard line, and it will be fourth down for Texas Tech. 7:46 remaining. Red Raiders, of course, aren't going to kick. No reason to. Donnie Anderson, and he's at the 30-yard line and got the first down all right, but just barely made it as he was stopped just across the 30. That's Wilson. Pass complete at the 23-yard line. Tackle made immediately by Jerry Shaw. Second and three, Texas Tech. Anderson in motion to the left. Straight ahead drive to the 20, and that will be close to another Red Raider first down. Third down and half a yard to go, and no doubt about it, this time they get that first down with a lot of yards to spare, moving clear inside the Cougar 15-yard line. Donnie Anderson carrying. 5:53, the time remaining in the ballgame. Tech leads it by a wide margin, 28-10. Fumble, and Red Raiders, I believe, got it just before it went out of bounds. And they will retain possession. A Cougar was after it and actually touched it, but a Red Raider then got it just before it went out of bounds. That's second down and 15 for Texas Tech. An attempted look-in pass intended for Balch. Incomplete. Third down, 15 for the Red Raiders. Wilson to throw and flips it out in the flat, complete, out of bounds at about the 17 and well short of the first down. Gill will attempt a field goal, and we have a new all-time Tech rushing record broken in this ball game by the great Donnie Anderson. What a great one he is. There's the kick, and partially blocked in there, and the Cougars grab it at the 9-yard line. Cougars put it in play just short of their own 10-yard line, trying to get something generated here in the second half, which has been, if you've been with us all the second half, pretty much all Texas Tech. Tommy Roth in at quarterback. He swarmed near the goal line, but there are penalty flags down, so let's see what the officials rule. It looks like an offside Texas Tech, which fortunately for the Cougars should nullify that big loss. Offsetting penalties, but at least the Cougars wiped out that big loss. Roth to throw. He's got a man down and hits him at the 23-yard line. It's Rich Sharon. First down, Cougars. About 4.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. Roth to throw. Being chased. Finally does throw it up near the 20, and of course incomplete, as you saw. Second and 10. Williams split wide to the left side, Cadigan to the right, and Roth can't get away this time and is dropped at the 9-yard line. Third and a lot of yards for the Cougars, about 20. Williams tries to run it out of the hole and can't get more than a couple of yards at best, and so the Cougars have a kicking situation, and they'll have to boot it from near their own end zone. Tom Kelly got it away, just barely. Two Red Raiders were in there, and Kelly gets a good kick. Up to the 35, and stopped at about the 40-yard line. Texas Tech will go on the offensive with just about 3 minutes remaining to be played in the ballgame. First and 10, Texas Tech. They lead at 28-10, 2:49 officially remaining in the football game. gain of about a yard on a straight-ahead drive play with Zanius carrying for the Red Raiders. Second down, a long nine, Texas Tech. Donnie Anderson, who recently, just a few plays ago, set the all-time rushing record out of the ball game, and you can see what happened there. The whistle blew, and Zanius apparently didn't hear it, and started to go, and they had to finally whistle him down. Clock continues to run, about 2 minutes remaining. Third down, 5.5. No gain and a loss of about 2 yards as the Cougars' right defensive side moved in, and Wally Dempsey leading the way. Clarence Williams, a single safety for the Cougars as Tech lines up in kick formation with a 4th and 6. Flag down, the kick is way short. Out of bounds over back of the Tech bench down below us, and the penalty markers on the field. Penalty was against Texas Tech. They'll boot it again, and Donnie Anderson came back in the ball game to kick it. Clarence Williams will not attempt to pick it up. It will roll dead inside the Cougar 10. Less than 1 minute remaining in the ball game. Cougars, with half a minute to play, have possession of the football deep in their own territory. Dave Peterson, and he goes out of bounds to get that clock stopped with 25 seconds remaining. Second down, Cougars. Cadigan throws out of the end zone, hits Williams on the far side. Clarence all the way up across the 30-yard line and out of bounds. Well, that fine effort by Clarence Williams was nullified by a Cougar clipping penalty, which puts the Cougars back inside the 10. Cadigan again to throw, hits Clarence this time on the near side, and he goes out of bounds at the 33 to stop the clock with just 5 seconds remaining. Well, this will probably be the final play of the ball game. 1st and 10, Cougars, just 5 seconds remaining. Peterson back to throw. Over on the side, intended for Williams, incomplete. The ball game is over, and Texas Tech wins at 28-10.
I'll be back with a final word from head coach Bert Clark after this word from your local Ford dealer.
Well, Bert, it got pretty bad in the second half.
It sure did, Bill. Actually, we got outgunned all the way around. Texas Tech came out with a real determined effort, and our football team, with a 10-7 lead, failed to rise to the occasion. And we knew that Tech would come out a fighting mad football team, and they just physically and mentally and every way you can put it, pushed the Cougars all over the football field. And the second half was our downfall. And, of course, we'll have to learn, and we are learning every day, that it's a game of contact and it's a game of courage. Evidently, we didn't display too much team effort in the second half, and as a result, we were soundly defeated.
And that wraps it up. We'll be back with you next Sunday at the same time with a filmed action of the Washington State-Washington game.